Teller and I love to play this greatest person in history card game that we invented. It's really simple. We have this deck with all the contenders, all the people that might be the greatest person in history. Then we each pick a few cards and compare and see who wins. So I'm just going to... I don't need any more. I'll stand pat. Go ahead, take all the rest. Put all the rest for yourself. I'll just take this one. Now, to play at home, you have to decide how to judge great. So you just invent some criteria. Go ahead, invent whatever you want. I'm going to bet all of this. You know, you might say humanitarian. I'll bet these two. You might say science, great science. You might say, you know, I'm going to do my dad's ring, too, my ring my father gave me. You might say technology. Let me just, yeah, I'm going to throw the, I'm going to bet everything, okay? You're going to see me? You're going to see me? Because I got lucky. I drew Norman Borlaug, so it looks like I win. Actually, we all win. At a time when doomsayers were hopping around saying everyone was going to starve, Norman was working. He moved to Mexico and lived among the people there till he figured out how to improve the output of the farmers. So that saved a million lives. Then he packed up his family and moved to India, where in spite of a war with Pakistan, he managed to introduce new wheat strains that quadrupled their food output. So that saved, like, another million. You get it? But he wasn't done. He did the same thing with a new rice in China. He's done the same thing in Africa, and as much of Africa as he's allowed to visit. When he won the Nobel Prize in 1970, they said he had saved a billion people. That's billion! Buh! That's Carl Sagan billion with a B! And most of them were a different race from him. Norman is the greatest human being. And you probably never heard of him.